Hope you're doing well today. What we need to talk about in this video is we want to discuss systems of equations, but this time involving problem solving. Now, so far we've learned three different ways to solve a system of equations. You can graph the two linear equations and see where they intersect, if they do intersect. That is not the easiest way to solve, but if you need to see visually what the algebra looks like, that's the way to go. The other two methods, which is substitution and elimination, will be the ways that we solve our systems here, but we have to set up the system. So this is the first time we've run into word problems that create a system that we have to solve. So I'll show you several of these examples so you have a good toolkit to go back to help you with the homework problems. Notice we have two different things going on here. When I read this, it says the sum of two numbers, pretend there's an S right there, is negative 18. One number is 40 more than the other. Find the numbers. Okay. Now, when you read a problem, first of all, you've got to decide what you know and what you don't know. Okay. It says the sum of two numbers is negative 18. Well, what does that mean? Well, that means sum is add. So we're going to add two numbers and it equals negative 18. But what are the two numbers? Well, that's what we're supposed to find, right? We don't know what those two numbers are, so we need to use variables in this situation. And this is entirely up to you what you want to call them. Sometimes the homework suggests what you call them. This problem didn't. So let's just call the numbers X and Y, okay? So if it says the sum of two numbers is negative 18, that means add X plus Y equals negative 18, okay? So first equation handled. Now let's go on to move on. One number is 40 more than the other number, okay? Now we don't know which one it is, X or Y, but that doesn't matter. So one number, this number, X, is means equals 40 more than the other number. Now how do you write 40 more than something else? Well, we know the other number is Y, and 40 more than Y would be plus 40. Okay, so we have our two equations. Now we set them up as a system. So this problem would look like this. X plus Y equals negative 18 and X is equal to Y plus 40. And remember I had the little curly brackets. There you go. So now we're asked to solve this system of inequalities. Now remember, you've got two methods. You've got the substitution method and you've got the elimination method. The elimination method, the last one we learned, is easiest when the X's and Y's are already lined up. Now don't mistake this for lined up, right? This X is under this X, this Y is under this Y, but this has got an equals and this has got a plus. They are not lined up. They'd have to be on the same side of the equation. So I'm going to say substitution because look, this is already solved for X. So we know X is Y plus 40. If we move this X right here and replace it with what X is, Y plus 40, that is the substitution method, and that is the easiest way to solve this. So I'm going to remove again this X and replace it with what X is. So Y plus 40, and then continue on with the equation. Plus Y, so plus Y equals negative 18. Now we have an equation, but it's only one variable. That's the thing. You cannot solve an equation when it's got two variables in it because one depends on the other. So what you have to do is have an equation with just a single variable, only y, and now we add like terms. 1y plus 1y. Remember, there's a secret 1 coefficient in front of there. So 1y plus 1y we know is 2y plus 40 equals negative 18. Now my next step is I need to subtract 40 from both sides. Just classic two-step problem. 2y is equal to. Now negative 18, remember our trick, you can always say plus between these and add. Negative 18 plus a negative 40 is a negative 58. Now I divide both sides by 2. So I have y equals, now what's half of 58? Negative is negative 29, right? Okay, so we know that y is negative 29. How do we find x? Well, remember, we have an equation in our system. Either you look at it here or you look at it here. X is equal to y plus 40. Okay, so I have x is equal to y, which is negative 29, and we add 40 to that, and that's going to give us that x is equal to, now you know when you had a, when you add a negative to a positive, you actually subtract, and you keep the sign of the bigger, which is positive. So 40 subtract 29, we know is 11. So our y is 11. Now we could check that by plugging it into the red equation or the first equation in our system. We know that 11 plus negative 29 is negative 18. That checks. And then on the second one is, we look at blue or down here, is 11 equal to negative 29 plus 40? And it is. So our answer is 11 negative 29. Now the solving, you know how to do. If what I did in green and after was an issue, you might want to go back and watch the two videos that come before this, solving systems by substitution and solving systems by elimination, because the word problem is going to be torture if you don't know how to solve, okay? Because we're going to really focus our time on the word problem, and I'll go pretty quickly solving the system. All right, so we have another problem. Notice it says the sum of two numbers, again, I left off the S, my bad, is negative 25. Okay, now remind me, what does sum mean? It means to add. The two numbers, we'll call them x and y, is, means equals negative 25. So I have x plus y equals negative 25. That's the first equation. I haven't even read the second equation. Okay, one number is 5 less than the other. So one number, we'll say x, it didn't matter if you put x or y, is, means equals, 5 less than the other. Now, when you say 5 less than, that means subtract 5. So that's y minus 5. Now, that's the new part. The remainder of what I do, we have done previously. And again, if you're having trouble with the solving part, please go back and watch the video and do the homework for systems of equations and systems, well, substitution and elimination. Let me say it that way. All right. Now, if I write this as a system, use my little curly brackets. The first equation is x plus y equals negative 25. The second equation is x is equal to y minus 5. Now again, substitution is definitely the way to solve this. The reason is, anytime you have a variable or an equation with your variable already solved for, like in this case, x equals or y equals, substitution is going to be the easiest way to go. So what do? I'm going to take what x is, which is y minus 5, and plug it in right there. Okay, so I have y minus 5 in the place of this x plus y equals negative 25. We know y plus y is 2y minus 5 is equal to negative 25. So the next step is I'm going to add 5 because I'm trying to isolate this y on the left-hand side, trying to get it by itself. So I add 5 to both sides. It gives me 2y is equal to negative 20. Then I divide both sides by 2, and that gives me y is equal to negative 10. Now, how do I find x? Well, conveniently, we already have one of our equations that says x equals y minus 5. We also have it written right here. So let's just substitute directly into that. So x is equal to y, which is negative 10, and then minus 5. So we know x is negative 15. If I write that as an ordered pair, it would be negative 15, comma, negative 10 for my y. Now, I do need to check it. I'm not going to write it down, but I am going to look at my two equations, my red one and my blue one, and plug in. So is negative 15 plus a negative 10, negative 25, and that is true. And then my blue equation over here is negative 15 equal to negative 10 minus 5, and that's true as well. So we know we've done it right. Now, the only thing the check doesn't do is check to see if you wrote the word problem down correctly. All it's doing is checking the system that we wrote down. So if we have an error in translation going from the phrase to the equation, then it still might not be right, okay? But we did a good job this time. All right, let's see what we can do here. And you may want to pause it and try this yourself. If you're getting these, you might can just scoot on through this video. There are more types of problems, though. Don't just stop it. All right, so we have 6 times a number plus twice a second number is 4. Notice again, we're talking about two different numbers. So whenever I'm talking about two different numbers, I like to use X and Y. So it says 6 times a number. That means multiply, right? So that's 6 times X plus, so I write plus, twice the second number. Twice means multiply by 2. So 2Y is, means equals 4. So that's our first equation. We've got it. Now let's read the second one. It says twice the first number. So that's twice, and we'll say the first number is X, because over here it says a first and a second as well. So twice the first number plus 4 times the second number. So that's 4Y is, means equals always, 18. So there's our system right there. Now what I'm going to do is write it in normal system form, which means we've got the curly brackets, and I have 6x plus 2y is equal to 4, and then we have 2x plus 4y is equal to 18. Now this system, to me, is not ideal to do substitution. Notice that in either equation, the x and the y is not solved for. So substitution would not be the fastest. It will work. Okay, don't get me wrong, you could do it. But what would be easier to me is to look at elimination. Remember, elimination, what you want to do is add down, like 6x plus 2x is 8x, 2y plus 4y is 6y. But it won't work right now, because when we add down, we need one of our variables to cancel. So let's just focus on our x's. The first one is a positive 6x. If the next one underneath were a negative 6x, they would cancel, right? Well, what do I do to make this a negative 6x? Well, I need to multiply it by negative 3. What do I multiply by negative 3? The entire equation. So the first equation stays as is. 6x plus 2y equals 4. But now negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. That's what we need. Negative 3 times 4 is negative 12y. And don't forget, negative 3 times 18. You have to do that as well. And negative 3 times 18 is what? Negative 54? All right, so now we add down. The 6x and the minus 6x cancel. Positive 2y, remember, say plus in between here. And negative 12y is negative 10y. And 4 plus a negative 54 is a negative 50. Remember, you subtract when you have opposite signs on both of these, is the situation. Now I'm going to divide each side by negative 10. That's going to give me y is equal to negative 50 divided by negative 10 is a positive 5. Okay, now that I know y is positive 5, I can go to either equation, the red one, the blue one, or where I have it in green down here in system form, and find y. So I'm going to go to the top equation of the red one, 6x plus 2. And remember, y is 5, so I'm going to remove the y and replace it with 5 equals 4. I'm going to simplify, so 6x plus 10 equals 4. And now I just need to solve. And to do that, I'm going to subtract 10 from both sides of the equation. That gives me 6x is equal to 4 plus a negative 10 is negative 6. And then divide by 6, and I get x is negative 1. So when I write that, that's negative 1 comma 5. And that's my answer. And I could check it. So if I plug it in the red, x is negative 1, so there'll be negative 6 plus 10. That is 4, that checks. And then I plug it into the blue one, 2 times negative 1 is negative 2, plus 4 times 5 is 20, negative 2 plus 20 is 18. So we know we did it right. The only thing that we haven't checked is to make sure we just wrote our problem down correctly. But we did, so we're good to go. Now, this is very similar to the last one. So similar that I think you should pause it and try this one on your own and see if we match. So our first equation says twice a number plus 3 times the second number. Again, you've got to call your number something. And I'm going to call them X and Y. And let me make the first one red like we've been doing. Twice a number plus 3 times the second number. So twice a number means 2X plus 3 times the second number, so 3Y. Is means equals, and negative 1 is negative 1. Now I want to look at my second equation. It says the first number, okay, the first number, which we called x, plus 4 times the second number. So 4 times y was our second number is, always means equals, okay, equals 2. And there's our system. If we write it in system form, just using my curly brackets, 2x plus 3y equals negative 1, and right underneath that, x plus 4y is equal to 2. Now again, notice how the x's and the y's and the equal sign lines up. So this is a good problem to use the elimination method, but also it's not a bad substitution problem either, and here's why. This x has a coefficient of 1, so it would be easy to solve it for x. But I'm a big elimination fan. If it's already set up like this vertically, everything lines up, then that's the way to go. Now what am I doing here? What's with this negative 1? Well, when I look at my x's, I have a 2x here. If this were a negative 2x, then my x's would cancel. Well, how do I make it a negative 2x? By multiplying, not negative 1, how about negative 2? There we go, that would fix it, wouldn't it? So multiply everything by negative 2. And when I say everything, I mean the entire equation. So the top equation stays as is, 2x plus 3y equals negative 1. But the bottom equation, I do negative 2 times x, which is negative 2x. I do negative 2 times 4y, which would be negative 8y. And I do negative 2 times positive 2, which is negative 4. Now I add down, the x's cancel, 3y plus a negative 8y is negative 5y, and negative 1 plus a negative 4 is a negative 5, and I divide each side of the equation by negative 5, so I get y is equal to 1. Now I could go to either equation, my top equation, my bottom equation, or the same saying that as my red one or my blue one. The blue one looks the easiest because there's a 1 in front of the x, so let's do that one. So x plus 4, now we know y is 1, equals 2. So I have x plus 4 equals 2. To solve for x, I'm going to subtract 4 from both sides of my equation to get x is equal to negative 2. So I have negative 2 comma 1. I could check it by looking at the red. If I plug in negative 2, that would be negative 4 plus 3 times 1 is 3. Negative 4 plus 3 is negative 1. It checks there. If I check the blue one, I've got x is negative 2 plus 4, and that does equal 2. So it checks. Notice I'm not checking it on paper just to save space and time, but I do suggest you do that. Always check. Now this problem looks a little different. It says translate into a system of equations and solve. Directions are identical. A senior employee makes $5 less than twice what a new employee makes per hour. Together, they make $43 per hour. How much does each employee make per hour? Now again, these can be overwhelming. The first thing you really want to do is ask yourself, what do you not know? Okay, we know a senior employee makes $5 less than twice the new employee, but we don't know what either one of them makes. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to let S be how much the senior employee makes, and let N be how much the new employee makes. You could also use X and Y. It's perfectly fine. I just used S and N to help us remember what's what. Okay. Now it says the senior employee makes $5 less than twice what the new employee makes. Okay, so here we go. The senior employee is or makes less than, remember, it means you subtract 5, but twice, right here, twice the new employee. So twice means multiply by 2. Twice the new employee minus 5. You have to think about that one for a minute, right? So a senior employee is or makes $5 less than twice the new employee. So I wrote twice the new employee first and then minus 5. So that one I know you have to think about. All right, now let's look at the second sentence. Together means the senior employee and the new employee make $43 an hour. So together, what does that really mean? We're adding. So if I add the senior employee plus the new employee, we know that it totals 43. Now that's the hard part, y'all. That's our system. So if I write that as a system of equations, I know I have S is equal to 2N minus 5, and I have S plus N is equal to 43. Okay? Now, the next thing is how do we want to solve this system? Do we want to use elimination? Well, to answer that, are the S's and the N's and the equals lined up? They're not. So maybe that's not the easiest way to do it. Substitution is the winner here. You know why? Because it's already S equals. And any time you have a variable equals, you can take that value for S and plug it in for the S in the other one. So I'm going to write the second equation down, but I'm going to remove this S and replace it with what it is. So I have 2N minus 5. Now that's my S. Plus N. So I put plus N equals 43. Now add like terms. I've got 2N plus 1N. That's 3N minus 5 equals 43. Next, I'm going to add 5 to both sides of the equation, because remember, I'm trying to solve for n. So I have 3n is equal to 43 plus 5 is 48. And now I'm going to rewrite it over here. 3n equals to 48. I'm going to divide both sides by 3. And we know 48 divided by 3 is 16. So the new employee makes $16 per hour. Well, how do I find out what the senior employee makes? Well, remember, we have a formula. The first one, S equals 2N minus 5. So 2, we know N is now 16 minus 5. 2 times 16 is 32 minus 5. And so we know the senior employee makes $27 per hour. So this is the new guy, and this is the senior employee. Okay, this might be one you want to pause and try. It's similar to the last one. You're not talking about a salary, but you're talking about relating two different people together. So pick your variables and then see if you can't set up the equations. So how'd it go? So Jake's dad is 6 more than 3 times Jake's age. Now, your variables, you could call them X and Y if you want to. But I think it'd be easier to call Jake's dad, D, and Jake, J. Right? This is entirely up to you, unless the problem says that, you know, Jake's dad is X and Jake is Y. Other than that, you pick it how you want to pick it. So, let's see. Jake's dad is. You know, is means equals Y. So, Jake's dad, D, is. Now, 6 more than means we add 6. That's what 6 more than means. 3 times Jake's age. Okay, 3 times Jake's age. And we know Jake's age is J. That's what we call J. So 3 times that would be 3 J's. And then 6 more than that is plus 6. Now, remember, whenever it says 6 less or 6 more, you put that at the end. 6 more than is add, less than is subtract. Okay, now, the other equation, it says the sum, you know what that means, to add, of their ages is 42. So, dad plus Jake added together is equal to 42. Okay, now, we solve the system. Okay, so let's write the system. D is equal to 3J plus 6, and then the other one is D plus J is equal to 42. Now, this system, notice the D's and the J's and the equals are not nicely lined up. But D is solved. So, I'm going to use the substitution method. I know D is 3J plus 6, and I'm going to remove this. Let me undo that. I'm going to remove the D and replace it with what D is, which is 3J plus 6. Okay, so this D, 3J plus 6, is going in for this D. Now, when I do that, I've got, again, I'm removing this D and writing 3J plus 6, and then plus J equals 42. So, I wrote this exact equation down where this is D plus J equals 42. You with me? Now, we add like terms, because this left-hand side has like terms. I've got 3J plus 1J. Remember, there's a 1 always in front of a variable. That's the coefficient. 3J plus 1J is 4J plus 6 is equal to 42. Now it's just to solve for j, so I need to subtract both sides of the equation by 6. 42 subtract 6 is 36. I divide both sides by 4, and I get j is equal to 36 divided by 4, we know is 9. So we know how old Jake is. He's 9. Okay? Now, how do I find out how old Dad is? Well, we have our very first equation in our system is Dad is equal to 3 times Jake plus 6. So Dad is equal to, again, 3. Jake is 9 plus 6. 3 times 9 is 27 plus 6. So Dad is 33. So Jake, be formal about this, is 9 years old. And Dad, or Jake's dad, is 33 years old. And that's my final answer. Now we know Aaron spent 30 minutes on a rowing machine and 20 minutes lifting weights at the gym. And she burned 430 calories. During her next visit to the gym, she spent 50 minutes on the rowing machine and 10 minutes lifting weights and burned 600 calories. I'm sorry. How many calories did she burn for each minute on the rowing machine? How many calories did she burn for each minute lifting weights? So first, you know, we're always finding our variables. But what are we trying to find? How many calories did she burn for rowing, and how many calories did she burn lifting weights, right? Okay, so that means that needs to be our variable, okay? Let's call R rowing. So R is the calories burned rowing, okay? And then what's the other one? Lifting weights. So I'm going to put W. L would have worked too, right? So W is the calories burned lifting weights. All right, so that helps a lot. Now we've got a place to get started. So our first equation, it says she spent 30 minutes on the rowing machine and 20 minutes lifting weights. Now that R is per minute, okay? Calories burned rowing per minute. Okay, and calories burned lifting weights per minute. So if she does 30 minutes of rowing, that would be 30R plus 20 minutes of lifting weights, that would be 20W. And then how many calories did she burn that time? 430. Now the next equation said her next visit, she spent 50 minutes rowing, so that's 50R plus 10 minutes lifting weights, so 10W, and how many calories did she burn that time? 600. So that's our system right there. So we have 30 minutes of rowing plus 20 minutes of lifting weights is 430, and then we have 50 minutes of rowing plus 10 minutes of lifting weights is 600. And notice how your R's, your W's, and your equals, they're all lined up. So the elimination method is the best one here. And to eliminate, remember, you want to add down and either your R's or W's cancel. Now, to get my R's to cancel, I have to do more work. So let's look at our W's. Look, I can multiply this second equation. How about by negative 2? Why? Because 10 times negative 2 is negative 20. And a positive 20 and a negative 20 will cancel out. So let's do that. Okay, I'm going to rewrite my problem over here in black. Let's go to the top. So I've got 30R plus 20W equals 430. It did not mess with the first equation at all. For the second equation, I have to multiply everything by negative 2. So that's negative 100R minus 20W is equal to negative 1,200. All right, 30R and a negative 100R is negative 70R is equal to 430 minus 1,200 equals negative 1,170. Remember, we're trying to get the R by itself, so I need to divide this side by negative 70 and divide this side by negative 70. And we'll use my trusty calculator now and get R is equal to, so negative 1,170 divided by negative 70. We know it's positive. So when I typed that in, I realized it was a really yucky answer. So I thought, okay, it doesn't say anything about rounding in this problem. So maybe I made a mistake, and I found it, by the way. If you did this problem on your own and then came back to revisit me, you would know this already. But y'all, 430 minus 1,200 is not what I have right here. It is negative 770. And then you divide that by 70, and you get 11. That's a negative divided by negative is positive 11. That makes me feel better. So if you have a problem that doesn't say you're allowed to round, and you know a fraction is probably not what they're looking for, especially on word problems, check your work. And I just added wrong. That's all I did. So we know rowing is 11 calories per minute. Okay, well, what about the weights? How do we find out how much weights? Well, you go back to either one of your two equations, the red or the blue, or where we wrote them in green, it's the same thing. I'm just going to go with the first one. I have 30 times 11, because R is 11, plus 20, W is what we're trying to find, equals 430. And 30 times 11 is 330. I'm trying to make sure I don't make any silly mistakes like we did a minute ago, like I did a minute ago. And then I subtract 330 from both sides of this equation. And I get 20W is equal to 100. Divide both sides by 20, and you get W is equal to 5 calories per minute. So we know rowing is 11 calories per minute, and lifting weights is 5 calories per minute. Alright, so we've got another problem. Carly bought 5 pounds of oranges and 2 pounds of apples for $28.31. Carly's mom bought 4 pounds of oranges and 6 pounds of apples for $39.50. What is the cost per pound of apples? What is the cost per pound of oranges? Okay, so here's what we know. We have a cost per pound of apples. We don't know what that is. So let's call that one A for apples. And then we're trying to find a cost per pound of oranges. And let's call that one O for oranges. O can be kind of, hey, let's don't use O because that's going to look like a zero. That's a bad choice, right? Let's do R for oranges. Now, our two separate equations. So the first equation says Carly bought 5 pounds of oranges. So if we knew how much it costs per orange, we'd multiply that by 5 to get the amount, right? So we're going to say 5 pounds of oranges plus 2 pounds of apples. So 2 times the apple price, and that equals $28.31. Okay, now let's look at our second equation. So Carly's mom bought 4 pounds of oranges. So that's 4 times whatever the oranges cost, plus 6 pounds of apples. So 6 times whatever the apples cost per pound. And she spent $39.50. Okay, so there's our system right there. I'm not going to even rewrite it. It's right there. Notice how the oranges line up and the apples line up and the equals lines up. So this is an elimination problem. If we could figure out how to get either the R's or the A's to cancel, we'd have this made. Well, what could we do? Now, here's my suggestion. The R's, we'd have to do a lot of work. To get the R's to cancel, I'd have to multiply the top equation by 4. And the bottom one by 5, and one of them would have to be negative. Or, to get the A's to cancel, I could just multiply the top equation by negative 3. And I wouldn't even have to worry about changing the next equation. So let's do that. So 5R times negative 3 is negative 15R. 2A times negative 3 is negative 6A. Now I'm going to use my calculator. 2831 times negative 3. Is $84.93, and it's negative because we're doing a positive times a negative. Now the second equation, I didn't do anything to it, so I'm just recopying exactly what it says. All right. Now, when I add down, notice the 6a and the negative 6a cancel. The negative 15 plus 4 is negative 11r equals, and now I'm going to add 8493 to 3950. And since the bigger ones, I had to subtract, right? The bigger one's negative, so that's negative 4543 that I still have to divide by negative 11. And I get $4.13. So that's R, remember that's what's left over here, is equal to 4.13. So that's how much my oranges are per pound. That's oranges per pound. Okay? Now I've still got to find my apples, right? How am I going to do that? Well, I can use either equation, the red one or the blue one. I'm going to use the red one just because it's first. So I know 5 times R is 4.13 plus 2A is equal to 28.31. And 5 times 4.13 is 20.65 plus 2A is $28.31. I'm going to subtract $20.65 from both sides of this equation. Remember, the goal was to get the A by itself. So 2A is equal to 28.31 minus $20.65, and I've got $7.66. And I divide both sides by 2. Remember, trying to get the A by itself. And I get $3. So the apples are $3.83 per pound. All right, let's try one more of these. Okay, Jason invested $28,000 into two accounts. It says the amount he put in his money market account was $2,000 less than twice what he put in his CD. How much did he invest in each account? So do you see how that's two equations, okay? So first of all, it's two accounts. That's your variable, how much he invested in each account. So you got the money market account, let's call that one M, okay? And then the CD, well, we could call it CD. Let's just call it C so we're not so confused. Okay? So it doesn't like two different variables, C times D. All right, now he invested $28,000 into those two accounts. So you know what? That's one of our equations. The money market plus the CD is equal to $28,000. That's just the two different accounts he invested in. Now the other equation describes how much went into each one. The amount he put in his money market account was or is, okay, so money market is 2,000 less than, that means subtract 2,000, doesn't it? Twice what he put in his CD. So twice means multiply the CD times 2, and then again, $2,000 less, we have to subtract 2,000 from that. And there's our system right there. Now, how do we solve it? Well, we know that substitution is the way to go because we have M equals. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the fact that M is 2C minus 2,000 and replace it in the other equation. So now I have 2C minus 2,000, and that's going into that M right there, plus C equals $28,000. Then we add like terms, 2C plus 1C. Remember, there's a secret 1 in front of that C is 3C. Minus 2,000 is equal to $28,000. And then I'm trying to get C by itself. So I'm going to do the opposite of subtracting 2,000, which is add 2,000. So that gives me 3C is equal to 28,000 plus 2,000 is 30,000. And divide both sides by 3. That's a nice answer. C is $10,000. So Jason put 10,000 into the CD account. How do I figure out what goes into the money market account? Well, you know what to do. Remember, M is equal to 2C. We know C is 10,000 minus 2,000. So M, 2 times 10,000 is 20,000 minus 2,000 gives me, the money market is $18,000. Okay, so $10,000 into the CD and $18,000 into the money market account. Does that add to $28,000? And it does. So $10,000 plus $18,000 is $20,000. And is the money market $2,000 less than twice what he put into the CD? It is, because twice the CD is $20,000 and $18,000 is $2,000 less. So we checked it, made sure it made sense. I hope you got a lot out of this video. Let me know if you have any questions at all. Have a great day.